Welcome to RPTV. I'm Craig Stagner. I am so lucky to be joined right now with a friend. I got to meet him a few years ago, actually, at Lebanon I-44 Speedway during one of the big events there. And I've talked about you to our fans on several occasions. They know you from videos and from talking about you. And most recently, from talking about your being up for selection for the SRX, the Superstar Racing Experience that's put on by Tony Stewart, and asking for votes. And so that's the main reason we're here to talk to you today. But in general, it's just good to catch up with you. So, Mr. Cole Williams, how are you doing today?
I'm doing good. How about yourself? Thanks for having me.
Well, thank you for joining us. And you were telling me just before we started this, you just moved into a new house. That's a stressful time, isn't it?
Yes, for sure. It definitely is. But we're finally kind of getting settled down and it's starting to feel like home.
Awesome. Awesome. Now, I was just looking up some things about you. You just turned 26, right?
Yes. I tell people all the time, I'm 26, but I feel 18 still.
Well, my wife says I act like, you know, that I'm all the time I'll make a joke and I'll say, can you believe I'm almost 51? And she goes, no, I can't. She says, you're a grandpa, for Pete's sakes. Act like it. So, now I was looking up a little bit. You live in Borden, Indiana, right?
That's where my parents live. That's where I was living until we moved to a new home. I'm in Charleston, Indiana, but I'm like a minute away from Sellersburg. So that's my hometown, Sellersburg, Indiana still. Right. So that's located out of.
So you're for those of us, because I had to look it up on a map, you're relatively close to Louisville.
Yes, about 15 minutes.
Okay. Yeah. Now, did you play any baseball? Because Louisville's such a, we know Louisville Slugger, and it's such a baseball area. Did you do other sports besides racing?
My main thing focused, honestly, with racing. I didn't get to do a whole lot of school sports. Usually how the seasons kind of worked out, I'd run track most of the time. It was the less injury. I had less of a chance of getting injured doing track than I did anything else. But I did play a lot of basketball and stuff. I play a lot of sports outside of, like, school and stuff. And we play pickup basketball and stuff a lot still now. But I guess the biggest thing is golf now. I've picked up golf. I've been golfing a lot. But basketball and golf are my two main sports I play outside of racing right now.
They say that golf is the most frustrating. Has it been stressful for you?
Always is, but I always tell people, I say, I try not to take it too serious, just kind of go out and have some fun.
Yeah, that sounds like a good deal. Now, I saw that you're a fifth-generation racer, so I had to count backwards. So you're great-great-grand, I'm guessing father. Could have been your grandmother, but I'm guessing your great-great-grandfather raced, right?
Yes, his great-great-grandfather came back from World War II and decided he wanted to go racing. It's funny because, like, the Williams side, other than my great-great-grandfather, they were all the ones that raced. Racing actually started on my grandma's side of the family. And then my grandpa and them kind of picked up onto it. And then all the Williamses, that's where all the tradition right there, that's where I came into.
One of the things that always interests me is the origin of – when I saw you were racing number 48, is that still the number that you use?
46.
Or 46 is what it is?
46. Anytime my family owns stuff, it's 46. Now, with the new team out down in Tennessee, Rackley War, that I run for, it's the number 26, which that's Willie, the car owner. That was his number all throughout the years he was racing stuff. So it has a lot of history behind it, too. Okay. So it's kind of running it.
Was the 46 family tradition number from your side? Was that the origin of that?
Yeah, my great uncle Mike actually ran the 46. That's where my grandpa and stuff, his brother, they were the big ones that ran the 46 forever. And actually, the blue car with the yellow 46 kind of originated from him, because all of his cars were most of the time either blue or had yellow with a blue-yellow mix somewhere on the car.
That's always cool when you see that, because that's one of those simple things that that becomes part of your history. There, the numbers in sports, numbers are so important and legendary. That's a big deal. So it's really cool. Now, you told me you just got recently married. How recent was that?
So December 18th is when we got married, which I think it's funny because my wife's birthday is the 19th, the next day. So I got wedding anniversary and birthday back to back, and then Christmas a few days later.
That's going to be an expensive month for you.
Going to, for sure.
Yeah. So well, congratulations on that. Now, I saw her name is Emily, and she's from Lake Ozark area.
Yes, yeah.
Did you meet her at the racetrack, or how did you two meet?
It's a funny situation. So my best friend used to work on the race car with us when we ran Lebanon 44 for the NASCAR championship back in 2013. And I introduced him to Lindsey Reeves, which the Reeves have been known around there forever. Well, they dated for a while, and Emily was actually a best friend of Lindsey's, and we met through her, and that's how we ended up.
So in the course of trying to set a buddy up with a girl, you ended up with one.
Yeah, that's how it sounds like. Yeah, that's how it works.
Awesome. And now, I did see, too, that you took business marketing. Were you dual enrolled at Purdue and Indiana University at the same time?
So I went to Purdue for a little bit. I was actually pursued for the longest time mechanical engineering. Was thought that's the path I wanted to go, and kind of got introduced to the marketing and sales side of things, and I found my interest a little bit more on that side of things than anything. So that's kind of where I focused with the marketing, and then towards the end of my time in college, my advisor actually told me, "Hey, you add a few more credits here, you'd be able to get your major in sales." So I ended up double majoring. So I'm working in sales at State Farm Insurance right now. I've been there for, I guess it's gonna be about 2.5 years now, so time's flying by, but loving it there. Great atmosphere.
Well, that's awesome. So now the reason that we most recently wanted to get in touch with you, so let's get to this. The SRX race last year was a pretty good success. It was a unique format that they had it set up, and this year they wanted to bring in some what I think they deemed as short track ringers from some of the certain tracks. So each one, I know that like Peavely, they have some kid named Ken Schrader. I'm not sure how that's a ringer when he's been racing for 50 years, but he's somehow going to be considered that. And there's some others. But how did they approach you? Did you approach them? How did your name get in that for the voting?
Yeah, so I guess we got phone calls a couple months before it was announced on the voting deal. Basically, the main guy over at Track Enterprise that's doing all the head of marketing, Austin Shuford, actually gave me a call. He's like, "Hey, we're doing a fan voting thing for SRX for Nashville this coming year in 2022. Would love to have you as one of the drivers on the ballot." And I asked him, he's like, "Hey, you'd be interested in doing it?" I was like, "Shoot, yeah, put me on there." Yeah. So that's kind of how it all worked out. So it was definitely a cool experience.
Well, that's awesome. And when we first started following it, there was a couple different people that that follow ORP TV that are close to you that would remind us each show, you know, "Hey, and I, oh yeah, that's right," or you know, we would share it and that kind of thing. So what was the emotional roller coaster like there of being, you know, second or so, and then dropping back and then moving back up? How was that tough? How did you deal with that?
I think the stressful part of it is you never knew where you really was in votes. Like it showed your placement, but you never knew if you were 100 votes behind, if you were 3 votes behind. So that part was kind of stressful, but they kept telling us we're really, really close. We're really, really close. So we just kept pushing off of that, and luckily ended up pulling it off. But, I mean, we just had a ton of support behind the whole thing, so I was just lucky to be able to have the opportunity.
Well, and then when we got the word that, you know, that you had moved into the lead, I was like, man, this is great, because I didn't want you – it's almost like leading the last lap at Daytona. I didn't want you out front too far in the beginning, and then all these votes come in. So when you took the lead in voting right towards the end, I was like, okay, this is where we want Cole to be. So how did you find out that you had been selected? How did that go?
So they were, the whole plan was there to announce it, because voting ended that Friday on the race weekend. We was racing at Nashville. It was the ARCA weekend with the Jag Series, stuff like that. Touring stuff was there. But I was running the Pro Late Mall, and then I got a last-second opportunity to run the Super Late Mall. So I was running double duty. Well, I was just got done at the pro late mall race. They were supposed to announce before the pros, and schedule got behind a little bit. So I was we raced without not knowing exactly who won, and then actually they rushed us a little bit to get into the super. So I didn't know until after both my races that I ended up winning. I said the way I found out is because we got wrecked out, unfortunately, on the first lap of the super race. Oh. Walking back from pit road with the car wrecked, and the guy says, well, congratulations, like, for what floor? I ended up wrecked at that point. He goes, oh, you don't know yet? And I was like, no, I don't know what you're talking about. He goes, that you won the SRX still. So that's how I ended up finding out that I won.
That made that wreck seem a lot less significant, didn't it? That took the pain out of it a lot.
Yeah, for sure.
So now you've got your family and your crew and all this behind you and all this support. I had told everybody just in meeting you, I was so incredibly impressed with how you presented yourself, how dealing with the fans. One of the big things now that I'm seeing in NASCAR is you're not seeing a lot of friendly fan interaction. You see that with, matter of fact, I saw that at ARCA there that day at Lebanon I-44. I saw one racer go above and beyond of the touring ones that came in to deal with the fans, and the others completely ignore them. But you were one of the ones also that not of that, you know, the ARCA series, but that was just super interactive with the fans. How important do you feel like that is for cultivating and keeping the interest in the sport, getting out there and being approachable and, you know, available to the fans?
It's definitely I think it's very important. I mean, without the fans, none of this would be possible. I mean, if you don't have the interest there, the money's not coming in to keep these events going on. So I mean, it's very important to make time for the fans, and they get your name out there just as much as you marketing yourself does. So I always tell people it's 80% of doing the marketing and talking to the fans and sponsors and stuff like that, 20% of actually doing the driving part of things. So it's definitely it's becoming more of interactive, I think, to be able to go out there and be successful and kind of put yourself in a spotlight compared to other drivers. You got to put yourself out there to interact with the fans and the sponsors and stuff. So definitely it's a key point, and honestly, I enjoy it. I think the most difficult part is sometimes you gotta figure out the path of where's that cutting point of you're here to do a job of staying focused at the same time and interact with the fans. So they're definitely trying to equalize that time, but it's definitely the fans are super important to the sport.
Especially after the races, seems like a good time when but you know, it's probably easier if you've had a successful race, if you've had a wreck and you're mad and that kind of thing. But it's almost like you don't want to kick your dog because when you get home from work and had a bad day, your dog comes and loves on you. They don't care you've had a bad day. They love you. And that's kind of how your fans are. And you don't want to, you know, dismiss that and take it for granted that they're there, because they're there supporting you through good and bad. And you see their shirts and, you know, it is really cool. And I enjoyed seeing, I've showed the pictures of you with some of the little kids there as a dad. That makes a fan for life when somebody's good to your kids. So now someday you'll have kids and maybe. And any plans on that, by the way?
He hit me with it. So it's like, he was already hitting me before we got married, but now she's really pushing, like, hey, when's the kids coming? So the pressure is definitely on right now.
Gotcha. Well, you know, and get those, all the racers seem to have the little kids in the little sprint cars now. There's like a whole second generation of NASCAR drivers out there with the Bushes and the Boyers and all of them racing. So
funny, all the family, they all talk about the future grandkids and stuff like that, and how they're already replacing my seat before I even have these kids. I'm not ready to get out of the seat yet.
You're only 26. You're not even, like, the seat's just getting good and comfortable, getting kind of wallowed in there for you. So, well, that's outstanding. What so this race coming up is July 9th at Nashville for the SRX race, right?
Correct.
Do you know where that is? That'll be on, was it on Peacock or do you know which network it was on?
It'll be CBS Sports.
CBS Sports, okay. I got the whole wrong network there. So it's on CBS, not NBC.
Definitely, I think NASCAR has a lot of involvement with Peacock. So you're close yeah. there.
The Peacock app is you know pretty good for picking up a lot of the racing and different things. So yeah. There's so many different ways to get it now that it's unbelievable. So on CBS, tickets will be available to be able to buy those because that's coming up. That's what, 6 weeks away?
Yeah, it's pretty. It's getting close really fast here.
Are you any butterflies about doing this, about racing with the against the likes of the people that are going to be there?
Not yet. We'll see when the weekend comes. I'm in a unique situation with that whole weekend because I'm racing our biggest race in the country for the late models is the same weekend at the same track at Nashville. So I'm running the late model and the SRX car. So I'll be really busy. So I'm hoping that me being busy kind of distracts me from getting nervous. But I always tell people if you don't get a little nervous, you're not ready for the go. So yeah, I definitely will feel once it gets closer.
Absolutely, you got to have a little butterflies. That just shows emotion. That's competitive spirit. Now this car that you're going to be driving, when do you get the chance to sit in it, to try it out, or is that going to be that day going to be the first day that you get any seat time in this car?
It sounded like the day of the events when I'm going to get the seat time. Wow. To get in the car. That plan might change. Right now I'm working with SRX, CBS Sports, of getting all like the marketing stuff like that, the boring stuff of the application, signing your name and stuff like that, getting your name registered for the event. But yeah, as far as I know from talking to him, it sounds like that day is where I'm going to see the car sit in and everything else. So, but we're used to that stuff. Drivers, we're used to adapting, trying to adapt quick. So we'll get used to it.
It's still gas, brake, clutch, shifter, and a steering wheel, right?
Yeah, we just got a big old wing on the back now. And that's going to be different.
That will be. So really looking forward to that. Outside of that, now that's probably really upped your possibilities for next year and going forwards, doing this exposure at it, no matter how that day turns out. Do you have any kind of timeline right now that you're looking at as far as this is what my goal is for 2022, 23, 24? Do you have anything like that kind of laid out?
I mean, the goal is always, even at 26, the goal is to eventually maybe try to make it to one of those top three series, tier series of the trucks, Xfinity, or the Cup Series. But right now, I mean, with racing, it changes so fast. The plans are always changing. I mean, tomorrow I could be in an ARCA car or a truck. I mean, you just never know when those doors are open, those possibilities are going to happen. So we just stick to, I always say, take it one race at a time. We got a race next weekend for the next race in Nashville. It's a little 50-lapper to get ready before the July race. So that's my main focus right now. Once that happens, I think the SRX thing will really sit in. But the goal is right now, of course, the long-term goal this year is to try to win the championship in Nashville. So we got a great team. Rackley War has been awesome to work with, and the car's been really good. We already got a win this year and had some solid finishes. So we're going to keep continuing what we're doing, and maybe we can win a few more and try to win that championship.
You mentioned one of your sponsors there. I know how important it is. Tell some of your sponsors there that you want to hit, that you want to thank for getting you to where this you are in your career in this year and to this SRX opportunity.
No, for sure. Good Lord above is more than foremost is definitely the one that I appreciate the most. And without him, none of this would be possible. But Bordeaux Metals, huge supporter of ours that's been with us for quite a few years now since we started at Nashville. Been a big supporter with the Rackley War stuff and all my late model stuff and racing career in general. But then, of course, Rackley War. Jeff Haley Constructions actually came on board, been a huge supporter the last couple of years and continues to keep helping us out. And he's actually came to races with us, been eating it up, loves it the death. So I kind of feel bad because I'm sucking him into addiction with this racing. Glenn Tilton over at Napa in Wyoming. We've helped them a bunch with their racing stuff because they're actually racers up there. Just by trading notes stuff, they appreciate our hard work to help them, so they've been helping me out some. But they've been a big supporter there. But can't thank them enough. Rush Trucking's been another big supporter. They've been on continue since Nashville. I got great supporters, great health around me. Rackley guys have been great with me. The War Bunch, Willie's been great to work with, and of course my mom and dad. They've been the ones that kind of started the whole racing stuff for me and been kind of leading me down the path that I needed to go to be able to get to the point that I am today. So without them, my beautiful wife, family, friends, fans, it'd be possible.
I was going to make sure I was going to go, don't forget Emily. You don't want to be on the couch in that new house already. So, yeah, you got to make sure you thank them. You know, sometimes if people forget how important that spouse or significant other is, even if they're not, she's not cranking wrenches on your time. She's there just supporting you and saying, I believe in you. And that's a level of support that's so, so valuable. And it's hard to put a number or anything on it. Yeah. And you can't forget it. So.
Yeah, she's a huge support group, but she likes to tell me what I'm doing wrong too.
Oh, well, does she try to give you some pointers?
Yeah, she does. When
you guys are going out, do you drive or does she?
It depends. Most of the time I drive, but she said I'm a bad driver. Now, I'm surprised. It was that possible. But she likes to drive every once in a while. But
if you would hit the corners like this, you see this mark here? Does she try to help you out?
You know, she's definitely a backseat driver.
Well, that's awesome. Well, Cole, I can't thank you enough for taking a little bit of time with this. And even though it had nothing to do with us, I couldn't be more proud and happy for you, your wife, your family, and your sponsors, and you as a person and as a racer to get this opportunity. I can't think of anybody more deserving and who will be more appreciative of that opportunity than yourself. So a huge congratulations to you, and we can't wait to see you and see what you do next.
Yeah, I appreciate it, Craig. I tune in all the time on Facebook and stuff, see you all's videos, and I appreciate the support and you guys voting for me. I definitely helped a bunch. So I'll keep tuning in, and if anybody hasn't been watching regular, I mean, you have a great show, so hopefully people will continue to tune in and watch.
Well, thank you so much. And they can check you out on Cole Williams Racing on Facebook.
And then I got Instagram and Twitter too, which the racing page is that's actually ran by my my marketer, stuff like that. My mom actually, I think, runs the majority of it. But then my Instagram stuff, my personal accounts, my Instagram is _Cole Williams, and then Twitter is @Cole Williams46. So if you have any of those social medias, want to check me out, that's probably my most active personal accounts.
And you can buy merchandise there.
Yeah, actually, you mentioned merchandise. We're in the middle of we actually already got the print made. We're in the deciding factor of getting who's going to actually print the shirts, but we're getting shirts made, and the pre-order should be out and released soon. So tune in, be able to check that out. That'd be a reason to follow if you're wanting any kind of merchandise.
Absolutely, and when you get that, make sure that you let us know and so we can get that shared, because I know the people are going to want to do that. And I'll make sure I'll send you an ORPTV shirt, and that way have something. Well, you may just want to wear it mowing the yard or something, but hey, I'll just be happy to know that you have one. So,
all right, I appreciate it.
Thank you so much for joining us, Cole Williams. I'll talk to you more in just a second. Thank you so much for being here with us, and fans, don't forget to tune in that race. I assume that'll be live that day, July 9th,
yes,
from Nashville, SRX over on CBS. POLL, that kind of poll, voting poll winner from Indiana, Mr. Cole Williams. Congratulations, Cole, and thanks for joining us.
I appreciate it.